예, 오늘은 한 사람이 One 세상을 can 뒤집을 the 수 world. 있다. One 세상을 can 뒤집을 수 있다. 한 사람이 세상을 뒤집을 수 있다.
I'm going to leave a God's message with this title. When you read Exodus chapter 19, God renewed the promise with Israelites who were out of Egypt. It is called the renewed promise at the mountain Sinai. What is the main point of the promise? Exodus chapter 19, verse 6. You will be for me a kingdom priest and a holy nation. These are the words you are to speak to the Israelites. God's purpose was to make people a holy nation. Who is the priest? The priesthood role is not only save his life, but also save others. This means that a priest should work for others. Also, a priest will get blessed from God, so the priest should lead people to get blessed. In the New Testament, Christians are called as the priest like a king, so we are the priest. We receive the blessings. Also, we help others to get blessed. Christians are called like intercessors, advisors, or prayers for others. In the Old Testament, it is described the temple's furnishings. There are two pillars. He erected the pillars at the portico of the temple. The pillar to the south he named Jachin, and the other one is called Boaz. The name of the Jachin is that God raised the person. The name Boaz is that the person has power. They worked like two pillars. The role of the pillars is to support the ceiling and the walls. Christians should be the pillars. This means that we should be to support others and work for others. It is like a concept of the priest. When you read the Revelation in the New Testament, the church in the Philadelphia recognized as one of the good churches. Revelation chapter 3 verse 12, I'll make a pillar in the temple of God. I think this verse gives us the important message. Actually, this verse is related from Genesis chapter 12. God said that you will be the blessing. Genesis chapter 12 verse 2, I'll make you into a great nation and I'll bless you. I'll make your name great and you will be a blessing. Before the Bible was revised, the verse was that I'll make you of thee a great nation and I'll be blessed thee and make thee name great and the sword be a blessing. You must understand the meanings of this verse. Genesis chapter 12 verse 3, I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curse, you are cursed, and all people on earth will be blessed through you. You are the blessing to give others blessing. You are the most important person to be a blessing. In some Bibles, it is described otherwise like a source of blessing. The passage of blessing or the pipe of blessing. I think a word looks fine, but the passage of blessing of the pipe of blessing is not suitable to describe a blessing because after passing the blessing, it might show emptiness. Probably, we can say that after passing the blessing to others, it remains some in the ways. This means that most blessing gives others that some of the blessing left are received. It shows us modest. It doesn't show a definite blessing. I think the best expression is that we are the source of blessing. We are the root of blessing. This is important. The focus of this message is on the blessing and the source.
뚜렷하게 설명해 주는 건 아니라고 생각합니다. 그런 의미에서 우리는 복이라고 번역을 했지만
From this, the grace of God should be begun from blessing. Churches and church members are the source of blessing. So, all blessings should be begun from us and churches. We receive the blessing, then church members are also receive blessings. This is a part of a church. Now, in this service, with grace and power, it should be overflowed on us. Psalms consist of 157. When you look at Psalms chapter 1, verse 1, blessed is the man. It talks about blessed. We should be blessed so we can change the surroundings. We as blessed people are in the service to worship God. During this service, it shows great power to influence the others. It cannot be stopped. When you just look at this service, it shows nothing, but this is important to us. Look at Abraham from Genesis chapter 12, verse 7 to 8. Abraham built altars on his way, and he built in again. Why did he build altars on his way? The reason is that God was with him. Through people's eyes, there was nothing, but with spiritual eyes, it was a great revolution. During this service, you changed your perspectives. We are in Hongdae area. Through your eyes, you can see nothing change in this area. However, after 5 or 10 years, it will be different with spiritual changes. I will give you an example. When a person puts his or her hands into water or jumps into the water, it makes waves on the water. Even it happens like this. How about you? You can change the spiritual wave. To change the surrounding, you should be in the service. Definitely, it shows some changes. From my experience, when I visit church members' houses for a service, I can see them to change their internal mind. They try to say their problems to me. They would like to heal their mind. After the service, they got healed and opened their heart from the touch of God. Then they say that, I experienced that God touches my heart. Some of them say that I have a lot of problems and unfixed their faith. But after the service, they say that I fixed my mind into spiritual waves. Also, some of them say that I have no ways to go in my life. But after a service, I can see my ways to go forward. Some of them have some troubles and suffering in their life. But after service, they lose the power to raise them up. With the spiritual waves, this is the true appearance of us from the service. When parents worship God with their heart, their children will be changed. When children worship God with their heart, their parents will be changed. When a person comes to service alone, he or her family will be changed. When you worship God with your heart, Hongdae area will be changed. Even Korean churches will be changed. And this world will be changed. We are the blessing. Blessing is not stay in one place. It spreads to others. It makes the waves of the blessing. Why is it important us to worship God all together? Some people give the service via the internet, but I think they do not really involve the service. People feel the Holy Spirit in the real service, and they feel impressed, and also they list the same grace. Now, in this service, you can see that the waves of the Holy Spirit shakes your heart and your internal mind. It happens at the same time. We can feel the same waves of the Spirit. This is the service. This is the blessing. You can feel the waves of the Holy Spirit and shake your heart. I want you to list the power of God and influence others with a blessing. You need to know how you can change. There are some ways to overcome. The first one of them is that you must be out of the protections of the world, then you must move to the protection of God. From this process, you must be out of fear. Genesis chapter 12, verse 1, the Lord had said to Abraham, leave your country, your people, and your father's household, and go to the land I will show you. From this verse, what are the meanings of your country, your people, and your father's house? They give you comfort. God said that, leave the protection of the comfort and come under my protection. The comfort makes you stay. If you want to stay in the comfort place, it is okay to be there, but it doesn't make you be perfect. So, God wants you to come under the protection. Maybe you feel fear to be out of the comfort, but you need to experience the process of tribulation and troubles until you move into the protection of God. The evil makes you not to go. So it gives you fear. Inner people are scared of new way. It tries to cut your ways to move into the protection of God. From this time, you feel scared, so you try to stay. In our life, when we feel scared, we just follow the rule of the world without any power. When I talked to one of church members, he asked me, how can I live without money? He looks like a slave. Like him, some of you act like fear. You are scared of not getting a job, not having a lot of money, or not getting married. This is the purpose of the evil. It makes you be with no power and no courage. The world has been changed greatly. From the time to time, from the old generation to the new generation, it has been changed a lot. For a long time, people wanted to receive $1,000 at their income for their living. They just wanted to live in a small house. They were happy with their life. As the time passes, they wanted to change more. Their income has not increased, but their life is getting luxurious. When people know the price of coffee, they were surprised by the price. Now, people spend more than $5 or $10 to pay for their coffee. Also, before the smartphone was out, people paid under $20 for their bills. Now, they use new smartphones and they pay more than $17 for their bills. A few years ago, young people bought a jacket which was under $100, but now the young people want to prepare a new brand jacket which is more than $1,500. Some of them have a part or full-time job to make the money to buy. Or some of them wait for the sale. People earn small amounts of money, but they spend more than their income. The world makes people spend more. The world is getting luxurious, and people see the world. They just follow what the world does. Also, the world people say is getting changed. Some of girls look fine and healthy, but they say I'm fit. They eat a lot of food, also they do on diet. They try to have a meal once a day, but they take a lot of money in a meal. Some of them are really healthy and fine. From others' perspective, girls want to be skinny and thin. They focus on celebrities. Most celebrities are really skinny and thin. They control the shape of their bodies hardly to show others, but girls want to follow them. It cannot compare with the girls and celebrities. Also, some people who are in 40s want to have the body of the celebrities. I think it is impossible. It cannot be comparison between 20s or 40s woman. The woman in 40s go to the skin shop to get massage in their face, then go to the gym to make good shape. They would like to be like woman in 20s, but they cannot be 20s woman. They think they are still young, so it can be possible. I would like to say that you cannot be like them. It is impossible. You should be act in your age. What do they act like young people? They focus on celebrities. Even in education, people focus education. Students are under pressure of studying. 30 or 40 years ago, some students went to university. The town they lived made a party for them. Only a few students enter university to study. For celebrities, only a few entertainers graduated from university. Most of them didn't go to the university. They didn't have any pressures to go to university. In Korea, 83% of students go to universities to study. Seriously, 85% kindergarten students enter elementary school. The rest of them do not go to school or go overseas or take homeschooling. They have some reason that they could not go to school. 85% of students enter the elementary school, then all of them go to universities. All students go to university. All parents push their children to go to university, and all students decide to go any university. As a result, no one cares about who goes to universities or not. They think entering university is a waste of money. In our church, some of you take a PhD degrees in their major. There are a lot of people who received higher education degrees. A few years ago, if people passed by exam, the neighbors make a party to praise him or her. Now, more than 1,000 people pass the bar exam, and more than 1,000 people graduate from the law school every year. No one cares about people who pass the test. It is common that people go to universities and they receive the higher education. The standard of the world is getting higher. It makes people feel fear. Why do young people feel fear? People who live in the older generation are satisfied with their life. Now, but the new generations want to follow the rule of the world. They want to be like celebrities. They want to have a higher education. They have a hard time to follow the rules of the world. They feel tired all the time. They cannot enjoy their young life. They live in a fear of life. The world is getting changed more, and it tries to ask you more to be changed. Non-Christians will follow the rules, but we are Christians. We ignore it. Do not follow what it makes. Look at David and Goliath. Goliath is represented as the world. He was tall and looked perfect. He had everything. It is described to him in 1 Samuel chapter 70, verse 4 to 7. He was over 9 feet tall. He had a brazen helmet on his head and wore a coat of scale armor of bronze weighing 5,000 shekels. On his legs, he wore bronze greaves, and the bronze javelin was slung on his back. His spear shaft was like a weaver, love, and its iron points weighed 600 shekels. His sealed bearer went ahead of him. Comparing the people, now, Goliath was the perfect person. He was perfect and had everything. Whereas, look at David. He was small, simple, and free. He did not wear any armor, and he just took 5 smooth stones and his sling in his hand. He acted freely and simple. We should be like David. We should be simple and free. Now, back to our passage. Abraham's house was in Uri. Abraham and his family enjoyed their comfort in the place. They stayed in the place without any worries. But God said that, leave your country, your people, and your father's house. He wanted him to be out of the comfort once. When you have faith and supply of God, you cannot fight against the things like Goliath that God gives you victory. This is faith. 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 49, reaching into his bag and taking out the stone, he slung it and struck the Philistine on the forehead. The stone sank in the forehead and he fell face down on the ground. The end of fighting was shown too simple. The faithful people come to fight. It will be simple. Christians should not act like non-Christians. We must pray when you have troubles and please do not listen what non-Christians say. Please do not follow what they say. Please do not follow what the society wants you to be. If you graduate from the good university like others, what will you do next? It does not make you be any different. Please do not be like others. If you follow others, it might not give you any important message in your life. When you rely on God with your heart, God leads you into a better way and give you victory. We need to look at David's life about how God trained him. He trained the heart of God. We should know what God's training is. We need to take care of weak people. When you take care of them, you understand what God's heart is. 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 34. David said to Saul, "Your servant has been keeping his father's sheep. When a lion or a bear came and carried off the sheep from the flock, the sheep is a weak one. It showed David's heart. When David showed the lion, caught the sheep, 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 35, I went after it, struck it, and rescued the sheep from its mouth. When it turned on me, I seized it by its hair, struck it, and killed it. He cried out, 'Please help me, please help me to save the sheep.' David showed two things. The first one is to rely on God, and the other one is to save the sheep. David relied on God, then he has the courage to save the ship. Also, when he tried to save it, he got the mind to rely on it. It showed two things at the same time. We need to train the two things all together. Even pastor and CLA students must take these things. A person who cries out the weak people is a prayer. He or she shouts to the Lord, "Please help, how can I do?" This is a priest. The priest has a responsibility to take care of his weak people. He might compass about the weakness. He said that, "I'm too weak. How can I help them out? Please help me." After God listened to his saying, he will protect the weak people with the Holy Spirit. Look at David. He said that 1 Samuel chapter 70, verse 26, "What will be done for the man who kills this Philistine and removes this disgrace from Israel? Who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God?" He already knew God gave him the victory. Also, he knew the heart of God. He said weak people and received the great power of God. When he relied on God, he made a victory. No one started to fight with the big things. People try to make good things to look better. They want to study more for their career, take a higher education certificate, but they are still in fear. Some of the people are rich, but they are still in fear. Do you know why they feel fear? They fight with Goliath. They already got everything they need, but they feel scared because they have no power. We have a knowledge to protect with people. God gives us knowledge to save others. Also, we have sick people like Zarephath woman. She came to Jesus to save her son. Her son was healed, and also she received a great faith. We must take care of weak people. Honestly, I enjoyed doing my God's work in this church more than the previous church. Now I'm going to the real mission of God. I can see God raised me in His way for His work. In my case, when I be church members' house, I can see their weakness, so I pray God's help for them. I can see the power of God. We must experience what David did. He saved the sheep with a lion. Also, he fought against Goliath. He did not care of fear. He believed God already gave him the power. He trusts his power. Last week, there was a funeral. In a funeral, there are seven services in a church. While I was preparing a message for the service, I thought of the family. I deeply meditate the message to deliver for them. In a funeral, many people might come to console the family. At night, I went to the funeral and then delivered the message to them. For the servant, I did not focus on the funeral. I focused on the broken heart of the family. I delivered God's message only for 10 minutes. I felt like a part of God. Also, so did they. I tried to understand the weakness of them. When thousand people hear the God's message, they will receive the power of God at the same time. David saved the sheep from the lion and defeated Goliath. So we cannot do like him. Please do not fight with the big things. When you protect small and weak people, you can see the power and grace of God. At the dawn service, a man often came to the service before, but these days, it is hard to see him. Last month, he never missed any dawn services, but these days, he rarely comes. So I found that he is in troubles over his business. He mistrusts God. He said that, I mistrust God, so I cannot come to the service. You know, when you are in troubles, you should come more than usual. In some cases, God bless him, so he has a lot of works and he will be busy. That's why he could not come. But in this case, I couldn't understand his situation, but he has a lot of problems in his business. He should come more. This is the time for him to come to the services. I think he has no faith. Why does he experience unfaithful? The reason is that he has never experienced to save weak people. He fights with the big things like Goliath. That's why he cannot overcome the challenges. He has a hard time to deal with the problems by himself. In our life, we cannot deal with only big things. Sometimes we need to fight with the small things as well. What is the blessing of God when you obey? It is to cover weak people like the sheep. What is the difference between Saul and David? Look at Saul. Saul trembled in his palace when he looked at the Goliath. Like him, in our life, we can be like Saul. We are eager to make more certificates and license to and learn more things for our career. In the end, the result will be fail. Saul failed to make victory. We should be break the rule of fear. We are not able to fight with the enemy by ourselves. When God gives us the power, we can make a great victory with the rule of God. Do you have a hard time? The reason is that you follow the rule of the world. You should fight with the power of God. Then we definitely win in our life. The last step is that only one spiritual person can be needed. Only the person can change the world. Look at David. He made a great victory. Also, Abraham became an ancestor of faith. He changed the generation. Only one person is important. I remember to Uman when I worked in my previous church. Ms. Kang, who graduated from Iwa Women's University, and Ms. Park, who graduated from Sungmyung Women's University, have been laborers. They prayed until 9 in the morning. They prayed for a long time. Then they spread God's message to others. So they brought new people to the church. One of them brought more than 100 people. I got the meaningful message from them. There are a lot of people in our church, but only one person can make a difference. It is better to have only one rather than thousands. Only one person can make a difference of a society. I'll give you an example. In a soccer game, all players are on the ground, but one or two particular players show differently. The players act greatly and make goals to win the game. They got fortune to lead the team well. So finally, it makes a victory. I want Hongdae New Church members to act differently and make a great victory. When I meditated with the message, I thought of a series of a book. It is called History of Three States. The series of the book are published in different languages. There are Chinese, Japanese, Korean, and English as well. Also, it's published in comic books. I often read the series revised by Oh Young-go. Thousands of people have read the series. and they have kept at their house. I would like to introduce some stories of them. The stories is about history of Chinese, and the main characters in the story are Yubi, Guanu, and Guanu. In the war, Yubi was not smart, so he made a mistake. His family was scattered. The name of the enemy was Jojo. Yusun, who was Yubi's son, was in Jojo's army. Jaryongjo, who was a commander, tried to attack into the enemy to rescue him. He had a son in his heart. Then they ran away from the enemy. However, behind them, the armies of the enemy followed them. When they approached the Changpan Bridge, Changbi, who is one of the great commanders, was standing on the bridge. He shouted loudly, "Please pass me. If you do not, you might die." From this part, he gave me a meaningful message. I was impressed with Changbi's attitude. On the bridge, only Changbi was standing to fight against thousands of the armies. And he shouted, "Please pass me. If you want to go over, if you do not, I will not let you go." In the end of this part, the thousands armies did not go forward, so they returned to their place. Like him, I want one of powerful person to act bravely. Please do not complain about your life and problems. You say that I will keep the promise like Changbi, who kept the bridge. Changbi fought against thousands of people. We can do like him. I want you to be like Changbi. I think David is Changbi. David made victory when he fought against Goliath. Abraham made a great victory in his line. A few months ago, I introduced one of missionaries. He was working for mission overseas. He had a hard time in the area, and he had a broken heart. The mission community sent him a letter. It was that you need to start working in a mission and take a rest. He replied the letter with only one sentence. It said that, "Thank you for sending me a letter," and he wrote one verse, Psalm chapter 18, verse 29. The verse is that, "With your help, I can advance against a troop. With my God, I can scale a wall." He's a great spiritual commander. When I have tribulation, I just rely on God, and I can advance against the truth. With my God, I can scale a wall. He's like Changbi, who is a great commander. He fought against thousands of people and protects his people from the enemy. This should be our compassion for us. With this compassion, I want you to make a great victory. You must break any hardship given by the enemy. You are the source of blessing. Do you believe it? I'm the blessing, so the surrounding will be changed. To make it, you need to move from protection of your comfort to the protection of God. You need to overcome fear. The evil gives you fear. Let's pray. My God, I'm the blessing. Please hold me to change the surroundings. Please make me the one who relies on God. Then let me make the great victory. Let's pray.